One month ago, I made a video called The Last Advanced Movement Guide You'll Need. Well, it turned out not to be as perfect as I hoped it to be. So in this video, I will explain the mistakes I made in that guide and share the movement things that I learned since then. I will go through things I got wrong, things I knew but just missed to mention in the video, things that I just wasn't aware of and learned since then, and movement rumors or misconceptions that I tested and could debunk. Let's start with the mistakes. While demonstrating that all legends run at the same speed, I said that
they all have the same base speed and movement. The different speed of arm animations is the only thing tricking you into maybe thinking otherwise.
But the main reason they feel slower is something called angular velocity. The camera you look out of in Apex is placed in the head of your character model. Since the legends have different heights, the camera is further away from the ground in legends like Gibraltar compared to Wraith or Lifeline, for example. This way, the floor seems to pass under you faster if the camera is closer to the ground. That's why the camera is mounted close to the ground in car chase scenes. And it's the same illusion that makes you feel faster if you increase the FOV in the game. In the section about climbing, I mentioned that
in this game you can hold jump while inputting a forward movement to climb.
But you only need to push jump at the beginning and not hold it throughout the climb. As long as you keep holding forward, the climb will continue. Not only does it make it easier to concentrate on your route and climbing to the right or left, but it also makes climb jumping easier. While we are at climb jumping, I really should have shown more examples of using it in a fight, since I don't think it came across how useful it actually is. I'm using examples of Xenox here, which I highly recommend checking out. He uses climb jumps constantly in gunfights very effectively and all around is just a beast of a player. His channel is linked in the description. I claimed that
the big difference between training and actual gunfight is that if you get shot, your slide is briefly disabled.
But getting shot only slows you down, and to slide you need momentum. So while being slowed down, you can't initiate a slide. But if you already are in a slide, down a slope for example, the slide will continue, even if you get hit by bullets. Here I also want to mention that Caustic and Gibraltar do not get slowed down when being shot as part of their fortified perk. Let's now go to things I already knew, but just forgot to include in the video. Let's start this with additions to bunny hopping. Sliding in water works, but slows you down instead of giving you a speed boost. But if you already have momentum before entering the water, jump sliding still works. And thereby bunny hopping also works in water to better keep your momentum. This is especially helpful to know while playing Pathfinder. I also should have mentioned that air strafing while bunny hopping is not only possible, but especially while bee hopping on flat ground, necessary. To keep a bunny hop going, you need to constantly airstrafe. Because as we learned,
but airstrafing does not only help in changing your direction, but also adds momentum to your movement. It's much less noticeable in Apex, but back in Titanfall, which runs on the same modified source engine, you could create speed out of thin air just by airstrafing.
So the continuous speed gain from airstrafing will make up for the speed loss from hitting the ground repeatedly. So you want to start the airstrafe before the hop, continue it through the hop, and only switch directions while being in the air. You can also bunny hop not only forwards, but backwards. In the movement guide, I enforce that you do not need to hold forward while sliding.
Once you start sliding, the only button you need to hold is crouch, which also lets you spin in any direction without slowing down.
This also means that you can turn around while bunny hopping and just need to inverse the side-to-side movements without having to worry about forward or backwards movement. Just stop the air strafing for a second, keep bee hopping while turning around and start the air strafe again once you have turned around. crouch walking is quieter than normal walking or sprinting. Be aware of this when maneuvering around or sneaking up on enemies. Next up are things I learned since making the movement guide. You can combine a wall jump and a momentum shift to wall jump over walls, skipping the climbing animation. Quick reminder, this was a momentum shift. But this combined maneuver requires perfect timing, and I practiced it for some time and couldn't do it consistently. And if you jump onto the wall high enough, you already get a very quick climb animation. So you have to judge for yourself if this niche technique is worth the 200 milliseconds or whatever it saves. And then there's zipline jumping. I have talked about it in my advanced movement guide, but I think most people totally sleep on this. Even if you know about it, there are still some ridiculous things you can do with it. I'm thinking about doing a separate short video on that. Let me know if you'd be interested in this. And at last, let's quickly get to things I tested and that turned out not to work. I will begin the section with something that, if it's true, can't be confirmed by the community, but only by the developers. I see many pros looking down while dodging bullets. There are FPS games where this has a big influence on your character animations and messes with your hitbox. In Apex Legends, it looks like your character is looking down a bit while doing this, but the effect on animations is so small that it's negligible. It could still be that your hitbox does something weird while doing this, but without DevTools, there's not really a way to find this out. Usually, if you drop down from the ship or redeploy balloon, you will enter a hover mode before landing. Right after skydive emotes came out, you could use one to skip the hover mode and land faster. But I tested this and it looks like it got patched since then. Landing in a crouch is not quieter than landing standing up. I tested this from different heights and on different grounds, and they always sound the same. Phasing while portaling does not let you place the portal further. If I learn new movement techniques in the future, I won't bother to make another update video. I will just include them in a Things I have learned about Apex Legends last week video. Thanks so much to everyone that commented on the advanced movement guide and made me aware of my mistakes and suggested things I could have explained differently. I really like getting critique if it's constructive. I don't always agree with it, but when I do and realize that you made a good point, it helps me to get better at creating videos. Thanks so much for watching till the end. I'll see you in the next video.